In the heart of Camelot, where King Arthur reigned, the Knights of the Round Table gathered, their names etched in legend. Among them stood Sir Gawain, nephew to the king, and a shining example of chivalry. Welcome to Cryptic Mystic Vault, where we explore the enigmatic tales and unsolved puzzles of history. Gawain's name resonated with tales of valor. His deeds whispered from castle to village. He embodied the ideals of knighthood, a beacon of honor and courage. But what is chivalry? And how did Gawain personify its virtues? Chivalry, a code of conduct for knights, shaped the moral compass of the medieval world. More than just martial prowess, it demanded a deep respect for honor, loyalty, and courtly love. A true knight was a warrior, yes, but also a gentleman, a protector of the weak, and a servant to his king. Sir Gawain, from a young age, trained in these ideals. He learned the art of combat, the graceful etiquette of the court, and the subtle nuances of courtly love. Gawain's early adventures solidified his reputation as a valiant and honorable knight. He faced down monstrous beasts, rescued damsels in distress, and always upheld justice and fairness. His loyalty to King Arthur was unwavering, his commitment to the Round Table absolute. Sir Gawain, it seemed, was the embodiment of chivalry, a shining example of what a knight should be. Yet as we delve into the epic poem Sir Gawain and the Green Knight, we uncover a more complex truth, a deeper exploration of the human heart within the rigid framework of the chivalric code. The chivalric code, a complex tapestry of virtues, served as a guiding light for knights like Sir Gawain. At its core lay honor, a principle demanding unwavering integrity and truthfulness. A knight's word was his bond, his actions a reflection of his inner nobility. Bravery, another cornerstone of the code, extended beyond the battlefield. It called for knights to confront danger, whether physical or moral, with unwavering courage. Loyalty, a virtue prized above all else, bound a knight to his king, his comrades, and his word. It meant unwavering support, even in the face of adversity, and an unbreakable oath of fealty. Courtesy, the final thread in this intricate tapestry, emphasized respect, compassion, and refined behavior. It governed interactions between knights, their treatment of women, and their conduct in courtly settings. These ideals, woven into the fabric of medieval society, found expression in countless tales of Arthurian legend. Sir Lancelot, renowned for his bravery and devotion to Queen Guinevere, embodied both the romantic and tragic aspects of chivalry. Sir Galahad, pure of heart and unwavering in his faith, represented the quest for spiritual enlightenment within the chivalric framework. The stories of these knights, passed down through generations, served as both entertainment and moral instruction. They showcased the heights of chivalry, the noble deeds and unwavering principles, but also hinted at its inherent complexities, the challenges of balancing personal desires with societal expectations. Sir Gawain's own journey in the face of the Green Knight's challenge would test these very ideals, revealing the human vulnerabilities that lay beneath the armor of even the most exemplary knight. The world of Arthurian legend is replete with examples of knights grappling with the demands of the chivalric code. Sir Percival, on his quest for the Holy Grail, faced temptations that challenged his purity and resolve. His journey mirrored the spiritual struggles inherent in adhering to such a demanding code, highlighting the constant battle between earthly desires and higher aspirations. Sir Lancelot, often hailed as the greatest knight, found himself torn between his love for Queen Guinevere and his loyalty to King Arthur. This tragic conflict exposed the inherent tensions within chivalry, the clash between passionate love and unwavering fealty. These tales, woven into the fabric of Arthurian lore, served as cautionary yet inspiring examples. They showcased the complexities of navigating the chivalric path, the ever-present potential for both triumph and downfall. Sir Gawain, standing at the threshold of his own trial, would draw upon these stories, their lessons etched in his memory. He would face his own demons, confront his own temptations, and ultimately define his own interpretation of the chivalric code. Sir Gawain, born into a lineage steeped in Arthurian legend, carried the weight of expectation from a young age. His mother, Morgause, was half-sister to King Arthur, making Gawain the king's nephew and a direct descendant of the mystical Uther Pendragon. This lineage, rich with both power and tragedy, cast a long shadow on Gawain's life, shaping his destiny from the outset. Gawain's early years were spent in the esteemed company of King Arthur's court, surrounded by the most valiant knights in the realm. He trained alongside Lancelot, observed the wisdom of Merlin, and learned the intricacies of courtly life from Queen Guinevere. This upbringing, steeped in the ideals of chivalry, molded Gawain into a formidable warrior and a paragon of knightly virtue. His early adventures solidified his reputation as a worthy heir to the Arthurian legacy. He confronted fearsome beasts, rescued damsels in distress, and always championed the cause of justice. His loyalty to King Arthur was unwavering, his commitment to the Round Table absolute. Yet beneath this veneer of perfection, Gawain harbored a secret vulnerability, a fear of failure that would haunt him in the face of the Green Knight's challenge. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more mind-blowing discoveries and thrilling adventures into the past.